probably 25 to 30 years. He hasn't seen any symptoms yet. What are the signs to start to see that someone is getting attacked or having an asthmatic attack?
Okay, so one of the causes of asthma is what I'll call, we have environmental factors. We have the genetic factor, which we've spoken about, and we have the occupational factor. So the environmental factor will have to do with the triggering factors that causes the development of asthma. Mm. So one who is allergic to dust, maybe highly scented perfumes, any irritants, anything that can trigger the development of asthma. Once the person, maybe in an adult age, gets exposed to that particular triggering factor, the person can develop asthma.
So that is when environmental issues.
Yeah, environmental. So that is when maybe you would get to know that I'm allergic to this, and then I need to take precautions.
Strong scented perfumes.
Yes.
That could be a trigger.
Yes.
Oh wow.
Yes.
Okay, let's move to the other factors apart from environmental.
Yeah, we spoke about the genetic already.
The genetic that is hereditary.
Then the occupational factor. So someone who works in an environment, for example, a carpenter who works in a factory where wood dust is produced could, the wood dust could trigger the development of asthma. People are allergic to chemical irritants. All these things can serve as triggering factors to the development of asthma.
For someone who works in an environment where it's maybe smoky or has all these chemicals, and you've never, or you don't have a history of asthma, is it possible that you, as a first generation person, can begin to have asthmatic attacks and then relay that onto your children?
Yes. It means that probably it was lying in remission once you got exposed to the factor that triggers the development of asthma. It's popped up. Yes. So
interesting stuff. Wow. So you could literally just, you know, be the first person who gets the asthma in your family.
Well,
and then it becomes a thing that flows through your kids.
Actually, there is certainly a family history. Well, you know, when you go to look into it, you realize that there was someone in your family that had a history of asthma.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Is asthma contagious?
Okay, so asthma is not contagious.
Okay.
Asthma is not contagious. It's not like flu or cold that it's not like flu or cold that someone gets from another person exactly, but it's not contagious.
Asthma is not contagious. But it's hereditary, but it's not contagious.
Exactly.
It means you can feel free, hang around your friends who have asthma. Come close to them, kiss and hug them without you getting asthma.
Yes.
I had to explain all of that.
Yes.
So that for people who might be afraid of, contracted asthma from their friends, I just want to know
you can feel free and hang around with your friends.
Okay, let me start with some interesting questions from some of our viewers before we even get there. The viewer here asking, can asthma affect your sexual feeling?
Wow. Okay, so I don't think asthma can affect your sexual feeling.
No. The sexual feeling. He said feeling. He didn't say performance.
I'm trying to understand what the person
means. It probably means performance. So let's tackle performance. Can asthma affect your sexual performance?
So there's been study that some people in asthma, we have exercise-induced asthma. So when they engage in extremely strenuous activity, it could precipitate the occurrence of an asthmatic attack. But I've not seen anywhere that it's related to sexual performance, so I can't say much concerning that.
That's interesting. Are there types of asthma, or are there levels to which asthma can hit you?
Okay, so yes, we have the mild and then the severe. So the mild asthma would be when the person has oxygen saturation rates that is low, the person is presenting the signs and symptoms.
What's oxygen saturation rate?
So oxygen saturation rate is as a means by which we check the oxygen level in a human. We use what we call the pulse oximeter.
Okay.
So someone in mild, the normal oxygen rate in a person should be around 94% to 100%. But someone with in the mild category, maybe oxygen will be more than 95%, and then someone in the severe, it will be less than 92%. So, and then you realize that the person is breathing very fast as well. In the severe,
that's mild.
Okay. In the severe, very, very fast, extremely more than about 180, but in the mild, it's just the person can go about a bit of activities.